What's up, guys? It's Hot at 7 RCT. I'm with another live stream. This one, I almost couldn't make it, guys, because basically it was a struggle this week to get a day off, and I got it, but with the skin of my teeth, basically, because it wasn't looking good, guys. But I did promise, however, that I was going to do a shoot 'em up stream, so here I am. For better or worse, hope you guys enjoy it. The selection is pretty limited. Hey, what's up, Rowan Rice? In the house, front and center. Thanks a lot, buddy. As you can see, there's a strange mix here. And if you're wondering why, basically it's because I picked up these two recently, AWA and Vector Strain. They're both indie titles from Steam. And it really caught my attention because I haven't seen or heard about these games. I think they recently came out. Well, recently, by that I mean like a few months ago. And of course, we have the staple of, you know, one of the staples of cave shooters, Mushihimesama, also Steam version. So we're gonna have like the full nice HD looking stuff going on there. I wish there were more cave shooters, but for the time being, the only thing available on Steam so far is this game and Garompachi Revival, I think it is. I'm hoping more comes around. Dejiga Games, the guys, the nice guys that provided me with a shoot 'em up test a few months back. I don't know if you remember that. Those are the guys in charge of doing conversions and stuff for cave games, so hopefully they'll bring more to the table later on. Now, before we go into the gameplay screen, because I have this set up, I had to do it last minute, guys. If something does not work, please forgive me. Let me turn off the music here, because I don't know how the sound levels are. Basically, I had to do this last minute in many ways because I almost had to go to work tonight. Had a little issue going on there with the boss. So, you know, it was a 50-50 thing. I didn't want to disappoint, especially you, Glowing Rice, and I know that you were asking for shoot-em-ups, and I wasn't able to do anything in these last few months. And with the Switch release, which, by the way, Glowing Rice, I'm hoping that you're having tons of fun with the Switch. And I saw that picture of the Wrap controller, man. That thing is bonkers. And yes, I did see a few weeks before the launch, they had some leaks of accessories from Hori, and one of those was the Wrap controller. Now, I don't know if the picture, because I was researching and trying to see if I could find somewhere else a picture or an article about that controller coming out soon. There was nothing on the Hori page, of course, because, excuse me, they haven't announced it yet. However, I don't think it's a fake, because if you notice, if you zoom in, there's a few features, Switch specific, that would be something that if it was made up, it would have to be somebody extremely creative and very savvy with Photoshop, because it has some Switch stuff specific right there, and it looks very final. So hopefully not only the controller but some more games, because believe me when I say this, I know there's gonna be a lot of fighter revivals. Hori is not gonna invest in making a version of their most famous, you know, fight stick if there's not gonna be any games to support it. So I'm really hyped to see what's coming up, especially in E3. But however, for the time being, I'm not in a hurry yet to pick it up, as much as I like it. Remember, guys, I still have, this is the my mainstay right here. It's old by some standards, because this is when Street Fighter versus Tekken came out. But this baby right here, Mad Catz of all companies, made an amazing controller, because this one, as I've told you guys before, it's made with Sanwa parts, which is the arcade brand for years on the arcade, on the Japanese arcade side. So this, to me, this is godly. Now, this is for PC, however, I haven't tried to see, you know, what would happen if I would connect this USB controller on the Switch. More on that later. For now, I'm going to go to the gameplay screen because I know that's what you came for, to check out these shooters. So I'm going to boot it up. Let's see what's going on here. Let me bring up Steam. So I'm going to bring this up. I don't know how much time, because I'm going to be spending with this game, with these games, especially the two indie ones, because like I said, I picked it up basically like 2 days ago. So I haven't gone through the options and menus and all this stuff. So you're going to be seeing it basically for the first time, just like me. So let's bring it up. Of course, as you can see, this is done with Unity. Many cool titles are made with this engine, especially on the indie side. So yeah, this one, Omnidream Creations is the people who made this game. From what I understand, the limited information that I have on this game, by the way, these are dirt cheap. I'm talking about like one cost me like three something and the other one like $4. I also understand that it's available for Android, I think. I haven't checked that out, but I found it interesting. It's not, it's, you're gonna see here by the layout and stuff that it has, I think this one was very experimental for them. As you can see, I created a profile here. There's some updates, of course, new jets and stuff like that. This one is more like a military jet fighter kind of deal, kind of like Aero Fighters and some of the more Donpachi and stuff like that, which is aircraft-based shooters. So yeah, let's go in. I'm not gonna bore you guys with options. So we're gonna go here. As you can see, what you have, basic ship, you have Fulcrum and you have Falcon. Any one of these are available, then the other, the rest of these you have to buy with stars. I haven't had any stars because this is like my first try, so let's go ahead and pick the Falcon, because I kind of like the Falcon, being that it's black and sleek and all metal and all that stuff. So let's do this one. Okay, as you can see, the first thing you notice, you have the gameplay screen, but you also have a HUD view, very detailed, by the way. You have some stuff going here on this side. I'm sorry that it's covered by the chat for you guys out there, but you have a number of achievements, I think, on this side. You have total stars, level best, high score, and on the left side, you have different ships. The one that you're using right here in the middle, the number of credits, mission, and this is the bomb missile allotment, I guess. And right from the start, it gives you the option to buy stuff, and it gives you $30,000 to buy. Now, since I haven't done anything yet, I'm just going to keep it there, and maybe later on we'll try the purchase system to see how that works. Okay, here we go. Since I have the arcade stick next to the mic going right, you let me know if the clicks from the arcade stick are too overwhelming. I'm still in the process of tuning everything or fine-tuning everything, so that way all I have to do is just go online and just hit a button or two and have the stream up and running, because it takes me quite a bit of time to set everything up. So I'm trying to look for the most optimal settings, but that changes, of course, you know, from game to game. All right, so everything is working fine. Damn, already? Press fire to continue. Okay. Now, so far it's pretty basic. You have some sort of power-ups for the weapons, the main weapons, and you have the bombs or missiles. Now, it's pretty nice, especially considering the price, guys. I mean, like $3, you can't beat that. Especially on PC, for Steam, this is a steal. Oh. Damn, I'm going through these credits pretty fast. I wonder, oh, boss, all right. Now, if there's something that I need to critique right off the bat, controls, so far, it's flawless. I mean, it's just controls really good, really precise. However, what I'm not really enjoying that much is the soundtrack. For some reason, it seems kind of tame for what it is. It needs kind of like more of an upbeat music, you know, soundtrack to get your blood pumping. Okay, so basically the missiles, they work as a blood deterrent too. There you go. Mission accomplished. Uh-huh. Yeah, it's kind of like, okay, so I earned a bomb. It's pretty straightforward, guys. I mean, you get a percentage, you earn some points, you earn some money. And then you get, now I can start thinking about buying stuff. I'm gonna use the mouse controls for this. Now let's see, main fire, nice money. I have $117,000, look at that. Support drones, oh, that sounds interesting. Let's try that out, ooh. Okay, but now I have $47,000 only. What should I buy? Should I buy an upgrade? I should buy an upgrade for the missiles. Yeah, another, I got 3 missiles now, so let's try it out with the drone. Ooh, I'm liking this. I am liking this. Now, I'm using the missiles, but somehow I'm not using the bomb. This needs a new soundtrack. I mean, when I go for the playthrough, I mean, I don't know how long this game is, but yeah, in order to enjoy this needs a rock and heavy metal soundtrack at the very least. Now, this is the first of the two games, because the other one that I have here, Vector Strain, it's kind of like a pseudo sequel to this one. And from what I could see, the graphics they had an overhaul. I mean, it's more futuristic, it's not aircraft based, but it's pretty awesome. Oh, I looked at the chat and boom. There I went. All right. Let's do. You can tell right away from looking at the graphics and how everything is working out. You can tell it's an indie game, and I don't mean it in a bad way. It lacks a little bit of polish, but what's here looks pretty good. Shoot 'em up is a shoot 'em up. It doesn't really necessarily need like really high-end graphics and stuff for you to enjoy it. You know that most of the best shoot 'em ups, or our favorite shoot 'em ups, are basically range between 8 and 16-bit graphics. So graphics is not really a necessary component. Ghostblade? Oh no, man, I haven't tried it out yet. I gotta check that out. 3D, yeah, it has kind of like a 3DO feel to it. now that you mention it. Kind of weird. Okay, so I have 100,000. What should I do? You see, I have buy bombs. And I lost my drone. I don't want to spend the money on the drone. I'm going to buy some more bombs. Hell, 3 bombs. Now we're going to... Oh, that's it. That didn't take much. I wouldn't go back to this one yet. Overall, I mean, this is like the first playthrough since getting the game. I tried it on the options screen and stuff like that, but this is like the first time I sit down to play with this game. It's good. It's not a bad game, and for the price, it cannot be beaten. However, soundtrack, the controls are there, but there's like an overall lack of excitement. I don't know if it's due to the soundtrack, but what's there, it has potential. I mean, and from what I understand, it has some updates going on, so maybe later on. The fact that you can purchase more ships adds the replay value of the game, but I don't know if the gameplay changes all that much with the new jets. If you can have gameplay variety depending on the aircraft, then I think this game is a pretty good shoot 'em up. Let's go into Vector Strain, because I know Vector Strain is a bit more on the technical side, is a bit a step up from this one. That's why I wanted to do AWA first. Or AWA, I don't know how to really pronounce it. Now, take note that Nintendo Switch uses Unity, or is compatible with the Unity, so we might be able to see some of the indie games. By the way, guys, on the 23rd, Snake Pass is coming out. Now, that title looks amazing. It's done with Unreal Engine. It's a puzzle adventure platforming game that has to do with a snake and stuff. Be sure to pick that up. We need to support these guys because they're taking a chance on the Nintendo Switch. And from what I can tell from the game, it's worth it. It's worth it. It looks like it's a really good game with the weird mechanics with the snake moving around. It makes for some interesting gameplay. And it's only $20. It's already up in the store and coming soon. So 23rd, Snake Pass, try to check it out. Hey Anthony, what's up? Welcome, buddy. Glad you could make it. Didn't miss much. I was just playing right now AWA, which was a military shooter. Both of the titles that I'm playing right now are indie games made from Omnidream creations. And I picked them up really cheap on Steam, and I just wanted to share it with you guys. Now this one, the soundtrack isn't much of a step up, but at least, I don't know. Let's see what happens. Right off the bat, we see that this one has a more futuristic look to it, and it has 3D graphics. We have the Predator, and we have the Raptor. All of them have, oh yeah, they have the shooting pattern like the bullet hell shooters. So this one I think is going to be much more interesting. I'm going to go with the blue one. And I'm sorry, guys, I already mentioned this to Glory Rice, but I'm going to take the opportunity to tell Anthony as well. I'm sorry that this was kind of like last minute, but I wasn't sure I was going to work tonight, and I had a little argument with my boss over taking the day off, but here I am. And I have, guys, I cannot overstate it, I have such a huge backlog of titles that I need to stream for you guys. I mean, most of them are on Steam, of course. I still gotta stream for you guys, using, of course, my baby right here, the arcade stick. I got a stream for you guys. Marvel vs. Capcom 3 Ultimate that I got it recently. Berserk, which is, oh my gosh, an amazing title. But ever since Zelda came in, it's like it overtook everything. Everything. Now it's all Zelda. So once I get, you know, I finish Zelda, which I haven't been able to play much because of work, I'll go back to streaming these titles for you. I still got Doom. Doom in 4K is amazing. And some, and Automata. Near Automata. Oh my god, that game is awesome, from Platinum Games, the creators of Bayonetta. The game came out for PlayStation 4, but thankfully we got a PC port. So yeah, I was trying it out, and it looks awesome, man. Yep, that's how Zelda is for a whole bunch of people. Oh, I'm liking the style of this one. It's a little bit of slowdown. I think it's something that I can work with in the settings to bring up the frame rate, because I'm not enjoying too much the slowdown. But it's looking good. It has some nice graphics going on here. Hold on a second. Oh, I can't do anything from start. Let me bring up the option screen. Let me check out the option screen real quick to see if we can get that frame rate a little higher. Oh, well, of course, the resolution is pretty high. That's why, and I need to change the presets. Let's play with high settings. Anti-aliasing none. Shadow distance. Let's bring the shadow distance a little bit down. Advanced water, advanced explosions. Shadows usually are the one that are more taxing in the system. So let's do that. Advanced explosions. I want advanced explosions. I get all giddy with graphic effects. Ironic, because I favor Nintendo, but you know, I'm kind of like a graphics whore sometimes. Alright. Let's try it out now and see if this brings up. Hopefully it'll help. Yeah, we're getting there. 40 frames per second now. Given that's 3D, I understand why, you know, in order to get to 60 frames per second, you need to have like lower settings and stuff. And since I'm doing it beyond HD, I'm playing basically at a 2K resolution. That's why it's kind of taxing. Now, there's something that I can't quite get here, and it's a little confusing, is that the bullets are very similar to the power-ups and the pods that you collect. It's kind of confusing. Probably something that I'll get used to in time. But I'm liking what I see. Mentos bullets, oh crap, yeah. Look at that. I'm getting my ass handed to me. Alright. This one I'm liking a little bit more than the A one. Even though I'm getting my ass kicked. Oh, look at that. So, by the way, Anthony, still trying to figure out when to get the time to sit down and actually do something. I'm thinking about recording a video, but I don't know how much time I have left for the audio thing that you told me about. Which, by the way, Anthony, you see what's going on with the Switch and the Neo Geo games? I mean, when I saw that around launch time, I was like, oh shit, we got Neo Geo games. This is something that's gonna give Anthony a nice kick in the pants. Because, you know, we've been, at least on Anthony's side, and he's been very supportive of the Neo Geo console, and seeing these games appear on the eShop, like the very first games for you to purchase outside of the main ones. But of course, Hamster, which is the guys who are handling the Neo Geo ports to the Switch, they committed a very huge sin by not having like Samurai Showdowns and by not having any shooter maps available yet. Hopefully, I hope that changes soon, because I need my Samurai fix on the Switch. So when I take a break from Zelda, I can do some slashing and hacking. Now I know the one that I love the most is the one that's very unlikely to appear on the shop, which is Samurai Showdown 5, the uncut version. That's the one that's uncensored. But if they manage to do a collector's, like Samurai Showdown collector, I'll buy it again. I mean, I purchased that game like 3 times for them. And I don't mind buying it again, to be honest. Damn, this is looking good, but I'm getting creamed here. Oh! Now the music is a step up from the other game, but not by much. But I like the effects, the 3D effects. I mean, this definitely is, you can tell that they had more time to develop the basic, the AWA model to this one. You can tell that they put a lot more time, and they kind of like mastered the Unity engine to make it much more interesting than the first title. Yeah. Look at that. It reminds me a lot of Ikaruga in terms of the art style. Now I can bet that if I manage to configure the settings enough to bring the gameplay to 60 frames per second, because right now it's fluctuating between 30 something and 40 something. Second, it'll be even better. The problem with these games, when they're not running 60 frames per second, there's a level of input lag. You cannot have input lag on a shooter. No way now. Look at this. That's the second game. I'm gonna keep these short, because I know the next one we'll probably spend a little bit more time with, and maybe I'll give you a bonus for you guys. I'll probably throw in Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom, since I already have the fight stick over here. Might as well at the end give you guys a look. I mean, it's an old game because it already came out for last generation for PlayStation 3 and Xbox 360. However, on the PC it looks really, really good. So I might do that at the end. Let's get going with Mushihimesama, which I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly. Not look like a fool. Oh, the cave logo. I love it when I see the cave logo. Look at that. Oh, yeah. Now, again, guys, I haven't messed with the sounds on this one. I only configured, you know, for you guys, in order to stream for you guys, I just configured the screen a little bit. So if it becomes too loud, you know, just write it in the chat and I'll lower the volume. Of course, we're gonna have some awesome music for this one. Now we have here in the modes, we have normal, we have novice, normal, range. I think I'm gonna go with range. First training, I got an achievement. Okay, shot type. Option type, bomb count. Yeah, I'm gonna keep these as is. There we go. Already liking the music. What the hell? What is this? I have... Oh, because this is a range. Oh no, wait, you guys. No. I wanna play the game. I don't want a special mode yet. I didn't know that range was training. There we go. Oh my god, what a doofus. I was training in a range instead of playing in a range. Yeah, we're gonna have plenty of that glowing rays. There we go. W power or S power? I'm gonna go with... W power. Math! Here we go. Talking about 60 frames per second, baby. Oh, look at that. Overwhelming bullets, baby. Woohoo! Yes, I love it. Never disappoints. So I've been itching for some Psycho shooter mobs. I gotta look in my catalog to see again. Play. Oh, look at this thing. No. As you can see, all the pixel art has been nicely redone for HD graphics, of course. There's still a little bit of limitation with screen space, because of course it's a vertical shooter, so you can't enjoy unless you turn your monitor on its side. You can't enjoy the full range of the beautiful graphics in this game. Updated for HD resolutions, of course. But even the original one looks beautiful. It is from a time that will unfortunately never come back. So any chance we get to appreciate these games, it's good. I love this. I love this. So much stuff going in the background. That's Scorpion. badass. Ooh, no! I am guessing, if I had to make a guess, I am guessing that Aaron must be working. But he hasn't showed up yet. Hope he's doing good. And he tried to call me last night, but unfortunately I was either getting ready to work, and we did the tweet, and I had to go work. I know he has been having fun with Zelda and the Switch, which I am super happy for him. Because, to be honest, ever since I know Aaron, he hasn't been, let's say, the greatest Nintendo fan, because I can understand that he was kind of burned at some point, and seeing him in the last few months enjoy the wide range of Wii U games that he's been playing and streaming, and now having fun with the Switch is really, as a friend, I really feel happy for him. But hey, it's the NX, baby. It's what we were waiting for. It's all about the games. Platform is here. All we need now is a steady stream of games, and I know the platform is gonna be a total, total kick-ass thing to have. Black that was done by Digital Games, that one is HD, but it doesn't have the full range of, let's say, the conversion like this one. This one you can tell that they did a full on conversion, a full on update. Ibarra Black looks really good, but you can tell that it was like mostly up the resolution. This one, they went crazy. Everything, you can tell. I mean, if you've played this game before, even if for a few times, you can tell that the whole game is real. Not just the resolution. All the assets. Look at that. Look at that. That looks crazy. That thing. Oh. Thanks, buddy. Now, by the way, Anthony, how's it going over there with the celebration? Hey, you must be going crazy with submissions from forum members and stuff. I, on the other hand, I'm just trying to keep myself awake when I have to, with all the freaking work nonstop. But hey, I can't complain. At least the work provides. I'm gonna give it one more credit box, and then I'll do the bonus Marvel vs. Capcom 3 Ultimate. Just to throw in something new. I know that doesn't have anything to do with shmups, but what the hell? Just like a little bonus. I thought for some reason the stream was gonna last a little bit longer, given the fact that it was gonna be three titles. But the indie games ended up being, I'm not gonna say lackluster, because they're pretty good for what they're for their price. But they're more something that could be appreciated if you wanna support the team, support the efforts and stuff like that, but it's not really up there. Vector's frame though, that one looks kick-ass. I'm gonna be playing a lot more of that. But AWA? Not so much. AWA really. Arrow Fighters is a much, much older game. And it has 10 times better soundtrack. Incredible gameplay. I mean, AWA, at least this the first one, AWA has upright system, which is nice, but I find a little disturbing that they have so much of the screen dedicated for HUD stuff and stuff that is not really affecting gameplay, and just a little small screen for gameplay. That's something that is kind of defies the purpose. But I'm gonna stop my ranting now. Why did I write J? No! I'm not JJJ. What is this? No. There we go. HTA. Shmups. Save replay data. Yeah. So now, beautiful, beautiful game. I hope I see some more conversions or masters of these classic cave games from Dedica Games. So yeah, I'm gonna stop this right here, and with your guys' permission, I'm gonna bring up Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom. Now, I haven't added it to OBS, so I'm gonna do this live. Hopefully I don't break anything. I know I have it full screen, so hopefully it doesn't screw up my stuff. Bear with me.
Capcom presents Marvel Comics.
Since I didn't prepare for this,
Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3.
It's in full screen. Just give me a second, guys, so I can take this out of full screen. This now. Settings. Okay, full screen window. There we go. This should be more than ever. Don't worry, buddy, I'm getting there. trying to work getting the screen to stay in one place. Okay. Now, all I have to do is add it here. And capture. Usually I do this offline, but since I decided to add this at the last minute, that's why I have to do this with you guys here, but you're going to see it in a few seconds. Boom! There you go. So now, I have to do this just bottom. Up so you guys can see. There we go. Awesome sauce. So now we have that there. Again, hopefully the sound is not too overwhelming. So I have arranged low attack and X button. The cool thing is that I have my buttons color coded, so that kind of makes everything easier when you go and configure the controls for a fighter. So I got low, medium, assist. LB is special attack. RB is high attack. This is kind of crazy. Oh, yes. LB is special attack and RB is high attack. Because I got them together, one with the other. Okay, assist. Okay. We have online mode, heroes and heralds, I don't know, battle for the fate of the earth. I'm gonna give it a try and just basically play offline mode arcade. And here are the options. Yep, it basically came out like 2 or 3 weeks ago, and I was dying to play this game, but since I kind of skipped PlayStation 3 altogether, so when it first came out, and since I didn't have the Xbox 360, I gave that to my son at that point, I really couldn't play it, so I was kind of like wishing they would do a PC port. But they took their good time, and now since they're advertising the Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite, which is coming in a few months, they figured, okay, let's now give the PC gamers a PC port of this, you know, game. So
normal.
Oh, come on! Don't change my controls. Chris from Resident Evil, Firebrand, Sprider, Ghost Rider, baby. I got Ghost Rider, and Hellfire, of course. You know, I have no idea how I'm going to pull it off, but I'll try. second character. Hey Aaron, what's up? Now guys, I have no idea how to play this game. I haven't checked the moves, I swear I haven't had any time. You're basically sharing this with me as I go through this because I bought the game, I purchased it, I downloaded it, and I just went in and tried maybe one character, that's it. I didn't even practice the training or anything like that, so if I suck, please excuse me.
Galore Island. The fight is on.
I'm gonna try and play it live. Used to play Marvel's Capcom 2. Oh yeah. If I find it a little sluggish, I'm gonna have to down the effects a little bit because it's just going to be played 60 frames.
Fight!
Yep. It's a little slow. So I'm going to have to come on, don't tell me I have to go out. Sorry guys. But I need to bring the graphics options a little down. Because it's cutting my frame rate and you cannot have this in a fighter. Sorry, no way. I'll leave it medium. Anything that'll bring... You know what? I'm not gonna even put anti-aliasing. Just leave the texture quality highest. Medium effects, that's it. Yep. Hopefully that should bring the frame rate a bit up. Let's do this again. I'm still finding it a little weird. Of course, after I finish giving this a play, I'm gonna go back to Zelda because
insect.
That's all I'm gonna be doing. With my time off, I'm gonna probably just eat something and go back to Zelda. Ah man, this is not good. What the hell? Now, to be honest, this is probably something that has to do more with the OBS settings, because I had the same issue happen to me with Street Fighter V, and every single game that runs with a needed, you know, kind of like a locked 60 frames per second, it's always a pain in the ass. So unfortunately, guys, oh my god. I have to go back here. I'll give it one more try. If not, I guess I'll have to work with it and bring it to you guys later. It was a bonus, remember guys? So I'm gonna bring down the resolution to 16 by 900. Let's see what happens now. I'll edit the scene. It's not bugging, even lowering the settings. Try it one more time.
Welcome to the world of Marvel vs. Capcom 3, where the finest heroes assemble. Get ready for the fight of your life. Ghost Rider, Duncan, Fletcher, 19.
Just try it next time, I guess. See if I can find the patch to unlock the 60 frames per second.
Own Wonderland.
I find it weird. It's only doing this while streaming, by the way, because I'm the highest anti-aliasing in full screen, and it was going crazy. It's just doing this because I am streaming for you guys. So, it has to be OBS.
Live and let die.
See?
Fight! First attack!
Well, one thing's for sure, it looks good, but it's like playing with molasses. This is... It's a shame too, because it looks so good.
We're boss over a Danger! Danger! Catch you later. Yes! Hellfire! Crossover assassin! Down!
Get you later.
Can't do it, man. It's driving me insane. There's no borderless window, so I'm screwed. I can't do anything. Let's try the lower settings, which would be kind of messed up. Nope, it's still registering 30 frames. Well, I'll have to look for a fix if I want to stream this for you guys, which is a shame, because the game running at 60 frames per second is an amazing thing. But unfortunately, I'm gonna have to test this a bit more and then come back to you guys later on. Let me see if I can do something here, because I'm feeling self-conscious right now. I wish there was something here that I could... Oh, wait. Let's do one more. Oops. Okay, don't go anywhere, guys. I know you can't see anything yet, but... Come on, loading. Come on. second, guys. I'm trying to... Get the configuration tool here and what I'm trying to do here is show you guys a little bit of Berserk since the Marvel vs. Capcom thing did not work out as intended. At least before I go show you guys at least one more thing. If not, then I'll just call it quits for tonight. But I cannot go, especially since I don't know when I'm gonna be able to come back. I don't wanna leave it in a sour note with the Marvel vs. Capcom thing, so I wanna at least show you guys one more thing before I go. Okay, 1080, full screen off. And let's have this. Yeah. This should work. Let's add it here real quick. I promise I'm not going to take much more of your time, guys. Just adding it to OBS really quick. I'm just moving here. Moving the game to a point where you can see it and not interfere with the chat and stuff like that. There we go. So at the very least, I should be able to show this to you guys. So you guys can hear me okay now? Now this one is Berserk. This one is... In any case, I need to load the bottom. I know this one is going to get crazy. Based on my favorite anime of all time, anime and manga, more manga because I've been reading by the series for years. This is crazy. It's crazy people who are sitting in this game. In terms of anime, there's a lot of revivals going on. We first had the series back in the 90s, which was only 25 chapters. That's how I first knew about the series. But basically, those 25 chapters or episodes they left us wanting more because it didn't even scratch the surface of how badass this series is. Nope, it was Glowing Rice, it was in Dreamcast, one of the versions of it. I can still have that. And yes, that one is more based on the manga than the anime. But basically, it was like one small storyline used for that one. Because this one has a lot of story arcs. This manga series has been spanning all the way from the 70s. Okay, and it's still active to this date. Now, it had a few years where the creator went into a hiatus for several years and it stopped. And then in recent years, it came back. The author came back and kept doing the manga series. Still ongoing. But basically, I have collected in digital form over 900 or 1,000 issues of this manga. It's amazing. It's crazy. It's very deep. It's very raw, visceral, violent. Just like I like it. So yeah. Yep. I was born in 70. So yeah. Yeah. If you see the original art from like the first manga chapter in manga form, you're gonna see, you can tell the art style looks a lot like the classic anime from back in the day, what was the name, Akira and stuff like that, where you see like more rounded faces and stuff. But all right, let me do this for you guys here really quick. I'm actually gonna play free mode because I think this one should be. And there he is, Gats or Gatsu. That is the hero of the series. Of course, in this game, this is the gameplay style is Musashi style, which is basically the warrior style. Which is basically you go ahead with a sword and you kill like 30 or 40 at the same time. Like the Dynasty Warriors. Well, this is basically a Warriors version of the series Berserk. Kind of like what they did with Zelda on the Wii U. And they had this Zelda, I forgot the name of it, but it's kind of like Zelda Warriors or something like that, that they had on Wii U. So yeah, let's go and do the Golden Arc. This takes place like kind of like the prequel, or this is kind of like in the very beginning before he becomes a Dark Knight, because he's like a Dark Knight, and you're gonna see if you check out the anime or the manga, you're gonna find out Guts is basically he's a mercenary who got caught in between becoming part of the Band of the Hawk, which was a band of mercenaries. But it's very complicated. I'm not going to go too much into it. The thing is that he gets involved into this ritual. And in that ritual, basically all of his teammates get killed in a kind of like a satanic cult kind of thing going on, ceremony. But he being the warrior that he is, he survived that ceremony, which he wasn't supposed to, and he got branded. That's a little mark that you see in his neck. He got branded for surviving something that he was supposed to survive. Now, from there on out, even though he's alone, and he's searching for Casca, one of the lady, the female members of the band, which he fell in love with afterwards, very complicated. The thing is that now, every day that passes, during the daytime, he has no problems. But during the night, every time he wants to fall asleep or during night, the mark that he has on his neck starts bleeding and all the dead start coming out and he has to fight him. So he has no rest whatsoever. So he has a quest to go and, you know, have, you know, take revenge for what happened in that ceremony during that night. That's kind of like minimalizing it a lot. It's more complicated than that and much more interesting. Try to check it out, guys. You're gonna love it. I'm not gonna even prepare. I'm just gonna go in so you guys can see it. Swat him like flies, baby. Wait till I build up the rage meter. Now this is back before, this chapter is back before he becomes part of the Capcom. This, at this stage, he's still the lone mercenary. He's basically like in between wars and different factions. And you can see, look at the sword. That's basically the sword that he uses at that point. And now check out. Check out the one that he uses in the main story, like after all the ceremony and after everything happened. Because by starting the story mode, you guys can see him like in the whole crazy thing. This eclipse, I think this is the one. Yeah. This is it. Okay, so basically this one starts out, him like in hell. Or at least that plane where the ritual goes on. Because the ritual, basically, the one you saw there, like on the floor with the helmet and stuff, that is basically his nemesis, his best friend, but the guy who let's say he called upon that ritual because of a little artifact called the Behelith. It's like a little trinket that it leeches onto your desires and it makes it come true, however, with a price. Now, the price in this case was to sacrifice the closest ones to you. So when he joined the Band of Hawks, the leader, he had a Behelith, and his wish was to become king, to become the most powerful man on earth. So basically, that was his heart's desire. When it came time for him to cash in, he did get his desire. However, the cost of the whole Band of the Hawks and sacrificing the lives of his friends, including Guts. So that's kind of a little bit more to the story.
Shinindama.
this is, of course, this is a very acquired taste. Like, everybody likes this type of games because a lot of people can get competitive. I, being the fan of beat-em-ups and stuff, I can get used to having a little bit of repetitiveness as long as the gameplay is fun. I mean, as long as there's something to do with the gameplay, something worth it, I can stick through it. And in this case, since the story is so bloody and gory, like the stories I enjoy, yeah, this one is one that I'm looking forward to. Just wanted to show it off to you guys. Not too much, but that's gonna be it for tonight, guys. Sorry for dragging it out a little bit more than I was supposed to, but I kind of had a misfire there with Marvel vs. Capcom 3. Hopefully next time around I'll have it up and running in 62 seconds so you guys can enjoy it. Thanks a lot for stopping by. The shoot-em-ups were pretty cool. Growing Rice, thanks for being supportive, man. You were the first one that to come out of the gate. Anthony and Aaron, thanks for stopping by. I'm going to go and play Zelda. Yes, I am. I'm going to go and play Zelda. So, see you guys later. Take care. I'll let you guys know when the next one is coming up. Take care, brothers. Manipular, jugar y hablar, no es tu forma de...